Hi everybody, this is Gijs again with another review and I hope you are doing well. This time I'm traveling out of my comfort zone because this is not a bike review, it's not even an outdoor product review. Maybe a little bit because it is a review on the Loom Cube 2.0. And the Loom Cube, it is a light that is rugged and waterproof and I've been using it for the last 3 months and I absolutely fell in love with it. And in this video I will tell you why. Enjoy the video. Welcome to the review of the Loom Cube 2.0 Portable Lighting Kit Plus, as it is officially called. But before I start with the review, I would like you to know how I got this product. Because I think it is important, since I am not a reviewer on photography or video gear. It was somewhere before Christmas last year, 2019, that I was contacted by one of the leading outdoor magazines in the Netherlands if I could do a Christmas feature for them on outdoor related gadgets. That gave me the possibility to contact also a lot of photography stores and distributors. And one of them was so clever to send this kit to me. I did the photography, we did the text on the product, it came into the magazine and then, well, I didn't forget about it, but all of a sudden it was about the end of February. And I discovered that I was using this kit almost every week for some sort of a reason. And then I thought, okay, if I apparently like this kit, although I'm not a specialist in photography or video gear, why shouldn't I do a review on it and share my experience with this set with you guys? Because, well, that's possible. Even if I like it, although I'm not an expert, why shouldn't I do a review? So I contact the distributor. They said, okay, if you want to keep it for a couple of weeks extra, then please, 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 please do the review if you like it. So that's where we are now. And I'm doing the review. What I would like you to know, that if this is the first time that you tune into my channel, that although I like the products and that I'm reviewing it, I'm not being paid by the manufacturers to make my reviews, none of them. I don't have any affiliate deals and I don't have any advertisements on my website. And the links that I provide, also below in the description to the manufacturer, for example, nobody is paying me or asking me to do this. It's all because I want to be a 100% independent reviewer. Now, after I've reviewed and after making the review on video, this product goes back to where it came from, back to the distributor. If you value my way of independent reviewing, then please support me by, well, basically subscribing to my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the alarm bell so you know when I uploaded a new video. And please follow me on Instagram and like my Facebook page. It really helps in making nice quality independent content for me. Now, this was basically the small print that I wanted to tell you. Now let's get on with the review on this nice set. When reviewing outdoor gear, I always find the weight and the pack size very important. So that's the first thing I always do. For the whole package, I measured a weight of 544.9 grams. And with my Stanley, this one, I measured a width of 230 millimeters, basically a depth of 170 millimeters and a height of 80 millimeters. Then for the light itself, I put this one also on my precise scale and I measured a weight of 121.3 grams and I measured with my very special tool the width and the height and the length as well, and it is square in, well, basically this direction. It is 43 millimeters and the depth is 1 millimeter longer. It's 44 millimeters. Now, let's go on and put this one out of the way. The casing itself, it's a soft case and I really like the way how it is constructed because the outside feels nice to the hands when it's cold. This is a really nice feeling. And the inside, this one is a foam inside. And the nice thing is that it's basically two quality density foams. On top, you'll find this more hard density foam so that it keeps your stuff really nice in there, and underneath it there is a softer density foam, which means that it will, well, when you get bounces into it. This will really dampen all the shocks to the light and all its stuff. It never ever happened to me that when I opened the case itself that something fell out. So this is really a snug fit for all the accessories. On the other side you will find a mesh with a zipper. Zipper. And there is a very tiny manual. It works, but it's not the best one I've ever had. A warning, so that will state that the light will get hot when in use, and I will get back to that later as well. And of course, here is the USB cable to charge the LED light with. But I did not use this one because I've got so many of them that I thought, let's keep this one new if I send it back. Let's start with the light. And let me take the modification frame off first, but more on this later. The light itself, it is made out of a solid piece of aluminium. Only at the back, this part is plastic. I don't know why they did not make this out of aluminium, would have been nicer. But this aluminium, and it's got these cooling fins, because, well, a LED, they tend to get pretty hot, and more on that later as well. On the back, you can see that there is this rubbery thingy. Behind this, there is the opening for the USB-C cable. That's the way how you charge it. And this rubbery thingy has a really nice fit. And because of this rubbery thingy, the LumCube 2.0 is waterproof according to LumCube. They state that it is waterproof to 9 meters or 30 feet below the surface. Well, I take this for granted. What I think is a little bit of pity is that the LumCube does not have a official IPX rating, because an IPX rating says a little bit more than just a manufacturer stating that it's waterproof to 9 meters below the surface. They state that you can use this for diving as well. I tried it outside in a puddle. I put it into an aquarium, and of course in the Netherlands we've had lots and lots and lots of rain lately. So yes, it still works, so it is in that regard really waterproof. On the top you will find two rubber buttons, a minus and a plus. And the fact that it's made out of rubber, it's really nice to touch with bare hands, but it's also very usable with not too thick gloves. And that's good when it's cold. The minus doubles as the on-off button. Now, on the bottom part you'll find a thread to connect the LumCube to a tripod or a gorilla pod, or to your thingy that comes in between the hot shoe and the LumCube. So that's there as well. Now let me talk a little bit more on the light itself. Of course it is a LED, and the LED has a color temperature of 5600 Kelvin, which is daylight. And for shooting, I like daylight lamps. My studio lights now at the moment that are shining at me, they are also 5600 Kelvin. It gives a very natural light. What is also very important is the CRI. And before I tested this little light, I never heard about the word CRI. CRI is a way, or is a way of expressing and measuring and indicating how well the light represents the colors of an object. Is red really red? And I did some investigation on this, of course, on Google. And when you have a CRI of 80, that's a pretty good basic standard. A CRI of 70 is, of course, less. The LumCube 2.0 has got a CRI of 95%. So in that respect, the light represents colors really, really true. I did not find one that does it for the fully 100%. I don't know if they exist. So if you know one, please leave a comment below. I'm really curious about this. Now, the beam angle of the light itself, it is 80 degrees. And beam angle, that means that how wide it spreads. Now I've covered almost everything about the light, except for one thing. When I mentioned the way the beam pattern is, the width of 80 degrees, well, you don't always want 80 degrees. And now we get into the accessories. The first thing that I want to talk about is this little piece. They are called barn doors. And when you look at it, let me put the light away. The Barn Doors, you probably recognize them from old studios, and they're quite fashionable nowadays in houses as well. You can flip these, close them, open them, so you get light into, well, a very small beam pattern or wide to the side, so you get a more cinematic lighting, if that's how you call it. Now, the good thing about this one and all the accessories is that there are four little magnets on every corner. And now we get back to this little piece, because this little piece goes on the front of the Loom Cube itself. And now I can put this one, and this one sticks really nice onto the light itself. And now I can adjust the light in every direction I want to. Maybe I should switch it on for you so you can see what happens, like so. And now I can narrow it down, squeeze it if I want to, make it wider again. Really a nice piece of kit. What I didn't tell you is that the light itself, let me take this one off, you can see it's pretty bright. And by switching to the plus, I can do this 9 times, and then it turns from 10% basically to 100% of full brightness. In full brightness, Loom Cube states that it produces 1500 lumen, and 1500 lumen is quite a lot. But lumen doesn't say anything, because lumen is just a way of telling how much light leaves the light. It doesn't say how much light hits an object. That's what we have lux for, and lux is a really nice way of expressing how much light hits an object. Now, for example, if I take my hand and I shine on it, then that's the nice thing about Loom Cube. They state that on full beam and 1 meter distance, 750 lux will still be on my hand. So then I know how usable the light is. Now, that was more on lux and lumen. Let's switch it up, because otherwise we'll go totally crazy or blind. And let me go through all the other accessories that comes with this kit. Now, let's get this one out of the way. And off, of course, and starts with the diffusers and gels. The first one is a warm level 1 gel, and this basically makes your skin or the environment a little bit more warmer. Now, this is the first one. Let me put it in here. Then we have a second one, which is a level 4 warmth, and you can see this against my shirt. It's really, really orangey. And the color temperature difference between daylight 5600, this one makes it 3500 Kelvin. So this is way warmer. Let's put it next to the other one. Then we have a diffuser, the light one. This just makes the light more diffuse. And oops, that was always the magnetic result. And we've got a stronger one, which makes it even more diffuse. Then there is, of course, the colors, to make, well, basically the environment a bit blue, which makes it a bit colder, of course. The green one, which I've never used. And there we have the yellow one, and you might see it over my shoulder on that side. There is a light with a yellow tone, so it gives it a bit more yellowish. No, it's on that side actually. And of course, here is the red one, which makes it really spooky. Or very friendly. What the good thing is that, and that maybe I should explain this as well, you can't see it probably so, but I'll make a detail of this, that on the top here is written the words Loom Cube. And that's really necessary, because if you want to click it onto the adapter, there's only one way to do this. Not because it's not squarey, but because the magnets are positioned not in a very square way. There's a little bit of difference in there. I already mentioned the barn doors, so we'll put that one over there. And then the diffusers, well, there is this, let me take the other ones off. We've got this one, it's a half dome. And because the beam angle is 80 degrees, when you put this one off, it's more like a sort of a softbox. The light goes basically everywhere, but in a softer way. I've used this quite a lot as well. And then we've got these two honeycomb structures, magnets, and I'll put them in front of my shirt. You can see that the left one has got openings that are a bit narrower, and the right one has openings that are a bit wider. The honeycomb structure, what does it do? Well, basically it forces light, I'll put them two and two together again, basically into one straight direction, but also with a little bit less because of course a part is also blocked. So this is a nice way to get light on a certain spot. Put them there as well. Now, the final thing is, and this is the one that I really use the most, and now we'll take the lamp, the light again, switch it on. This is the snoot. And the snoot is basically a sort of a funnel. And it's, when you put it on top of the light, you will see that it forces the light into a very small tube. And when I put my hand in there, and I'll maybe turn it a bit brighter, you can see it's a really nice round beam. This is the thing that I use the most for photography and some video footage at night, because this really makes me able to get light onto a certain spot. And especially if you do multiple exposures, I can put this one on several spots on the object when I don't move the object, then I can get some really nice magic light into the photo. So this is the one that I use the most, also outdoors. Now there's one other thing that I did already mention, and this basically shows how much detail LoomCube, how much attention to detail LoomCube pays to what they do. And this is this little rubbery cover, because this is a cover that protects the thread of this part, and that is really a nice detail. Now when I take the light again, this is of course the connecting piece to put the light, if I don't use the tripod, but if I use the hot shoe of the camera, for example, then I can use this piece to put it in there. And it's got this nice joint, so I can also switch, turn it around, even if I want to have it angled somewhere, that is possible too. This is really a nice piece of kit too. Little bit of a different setting now. I put the Loom Cube on my Yobi GorillaPod, and that's why it is so handy that there is this thread underneath it. This is the combination that I used the most with the Loom Cube. I already showed you that by pressing the minus button, I switch the Loom Cube on, and by pressing the plus button, it increases in light intensity. Now let's go back again into the minus. As you might see, this is still way too bright to do any decent night footage or photography. If you want to do longer exposure times, your whole object will be overexposed. But LoomCube came with a solution, and that is the low light mode. And you get into the low light mode by pressing the plus and the minus button simultaneously for 3 seconds. And now it looks like the LoomCube is turned off, but I will switch my studio light off. And now you will see that it is still emitting a little bit of light, because in the low light mode, it emits 1% to 10% of light. And by pressing the plus, of course, I increase it again. And by pressing the minus, I decrease it again. And this is very, very handy if you want to do night photography with longer exposure times. And I've used this quite a lot in combination with tents and my car, of course. Now, let me turn on the light again. And of course, by pressing both of them 3 seconds again, I turn back into the normal light mode. Now you've seen me pushing buttons the whole time, but is this absolutely necessary? No, it is not, because the Loom Cube is also Bluetooth connected. And in this case, it is connected to my iPhone. It's the Loom X app. You have to download it. It's available for Android and for iOS. And installation is pretty simple. You need to register. But you can uncheck the box that says that you want to have marketing information the whole time. So that's what I did, and I like my privacy. So that's sort of something you have to get around to. What the app shows is basically the battery status, and now it's 80%. And there is a on and off button. And with the on and off button, I can basically control the Loom Cube. And what I like a lot is that remote, I can now control the brightness of the Loom Cube from very little low light to full power, 100%. Let's get it a little bit lower. And what I also can do is, this is constant lighting, I can also put it into strobe 1 mode. And strobe 1 mode is flashing rapidly. But strobe 2 mode is even flashing more rapidly. And I don't know when you use this in photography or in videography. I really haven't got a clue. I use this in case of emergency in the mountains because this light is so bright that everyone will see this. So in this case, I think this is a cool feature for me as an outdoor guy. But there's one other thing that I would like to show you, and that's flash mode. Now in flash mode, the Loom Cube doubles as a slave flashlight. And when I take a picture of it right now, just off the camera of the iPhone, you will see it flashes, turns off, and now plum, and now I've got a picture of that one flashing into my camera. So if you want to do some photography and you need an extra flash, that's possible too. I did not try this a lot except sometimes with my iPhone because I have a good flash for my normal camera and I don't use a flash that often. One of the key things that is important to me when I take lighting or photography equipment outside is of course battery life or runtime. The manufacturer of the Loom Cube claims at 100% power mode a battery life of 90 minutes. And when you reduce it to 50% of power mode, they claim 2.5 hours, which I think is pretty decent for such a small light. But of course, as usual, I measure this as well. And inside my room, the one where I'm having my studio, it normally is about 17, 18 degrees. And I came to a runtime of 82 minutes, which is pretty close to what the manufacturer claims. And that is probably at a comfortable 20 degrees indoors. Now, there's one funny thing. Of course, because I do a lot of outdoors, I took it outdoors. And outside, it's been for the last couple of 6-7 weeks, about 6 degrees. And at 6 degrees on full power mode, I measured a runtime of 100 minutes, which is very strange because normally batteries work better or last longer when they're warmer. So I don't know how this happened or why this is, but I tried it several times and it's every time it's better than what I get in this room. So it's just that you know this. One good thing about the Loom Cube when you go outside is that the cube itself, the aluminium, gets really hot when it is on full blast. Indoors, I measured a temperature, a maximum temperature after a runtime of an hour of 54.2 degrees. Well, 54.2 degrees, I tried it. It's very touchable with hands still, so you can still use it. But I don't think it should get much higher than that. But outside, I still measured at 6 degrees outside temperature, a house temperature of 39 degrees Celsius. And to be honest, I really liked it because when you are shooting outside with 6 degrees, I don't know about you, but yes, I wear gloves, but when doing stuff with cameras and touchscreens, I hardly wear gloves. So when I'm getting a little bit cold, touching the Loom Cube is just a little bit of a small campfire inside this little black box. Now you know about the runtime, but you don't know how long it takes to charge the Loom Cube. Well, the manufacturer claims between 45 and 60 minutes, depending on the device you use to charge it with. Well, I don't know where they made this discovery, because I've been using this now for 3 months and I've been charging it a lot. I've been charging it with my iPhone adapter, with my iMac, I've used an adapter for one of my camera equipment, and I've used my ridiculously powerful Goal Zero power station. And even with the wall socket at home with the iPhone adapter, I only came to a time of 2 hours and 10 minutes. That is the shortest time I measured to charge the Loom Cube. With the power station, it was 2 hours and 45 minutes, which I think is ridiculously long if I'm outside in the field. And with the iMac, it was over the 3 hours. So whatever Loom Cube claims, at least you should double it. Before we head on to my verdict, I would like to make a little remark, and that's a remark about sustainability. If you're already following me for some while, then you know that sustainability is always a returning topic in my reviews, and in this case it's not different. What I do like about LoomCube is that every little part that is in this set is also available separately on their website. So if you lose, for example, that nice little half dome, then you can still replace it, and I think that is sustainable. But there's even more. For every $100 that we spend on the LoomCube website, LoomCube plants two trees in a place where nature is basically endangered. And they don't do this, of course, by themselves, but they do this in cooperation with the organization forestwe.org. And if you want to know more about this, just follow the link below or visit my website, because there's more information on this there. And maybe, yes, this might be clever marketing, but still, they could have chosen not to do this like so many other companies do. And now let's head over to my verdict. I can't stress enough that I am not an expert in the field of portable studio or outdoor lighting. Yes, I own a few headlamps and I have something that I use as a portable outdoor studio light, but it doesn't even come close if I compare it to the LoomCube in relation to build quality and performance. Like I said in the beginning, I love the LoomCube, and for several reasons. In the first place, it is very rugged. It is waterproof, and with waterproof I mean it can withstand pouring rain and I can let it drop in a puddle once in a while without any consequences. The battery life, for me it is fine. Even if you use it in the high power modes, it's still more than an hour, and that's long enough for me. If you use it in the lower power modes, the battery life is even longer. And also the light modes are very well chosen, and that you can put it into a low light mode for some, let's say, shooting at night with longer exposure times, that's something that I really love as well. With the LoomCube also comes the LoomX app. Well, that's something of a bonus, because with the LoomX app I can control the LoomCube from a distance, and that's really nice because it gives a different view on how I see lighting when I set it up left or right from the object, and that's something that I really do like. One of the things that I definitely don't like is the charging time, because the times that I measured doubles the ones that the manufacturer claims, and 2 hours or 2 hours and 45 minutes in the field is way too long for such a small light. One of the last things that I want to mention that I really love about the LoomCube is that it gets hot. And when I'm shooting outdoors, I really like this little warm cube. That makes my outdoor life a little bit more easy. The LoomCube 2.0 Portable Lighting Kit Plus that I review here retails for €239. And that is not cheap, but I think it is worth every penny. And therefore I rate the LoomCube 2.0 Portable Lighting Kit Plus at 9.2 points out of 10 total. I hope you liked the review and that it was useful to you. And if it was, please give it a like and leave a comment below. If you just tuned in after the verdict, then you might not know that I am a 100% independent reviewer. I'm not paid by manufacturers to make my reviews. I don't have any affiliate deals and I don't have advertisements on my website. And I like to keep it this way. So if you value my way of independent reviewing, please support me. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the alarm bell so you know when I uploaded a new video. And please like my Facebook page and follow me on Instagram. And if you do, many, 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 many thanks in advance. Enjoy the outdoors. Ciao, ciao. And now on to some bloopers, because I made many. Now it's turned off. Okay. Oh, sorry, I did something wrong. If I take a picture with my camera, nothing happens. Blah, 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 blah. LoomCube.
LoomCube. LoomCube.